In previous videos, I finished most of the mechanical structure of this RC excavator. Starting with this video, I will begin building the microhydraulic system step by step, which will breathe life into this excavator. A high-quality hydraulic pump is the core of an efficient hydraulic system. For this reason, I tried various solutions, but they all had different issues. So, I simply bought a salvaged pump, which is small enough. I was told it's used in a car, but I don't know its specific purpose. If you know what it's for, please leave a comment. The hole with a stepped surface on the end cap is the inlet port, and the stepped surface is for an O-ring. The other hole without a stepped surface is the outlet port. The flat shaft next to it is the drive shaft. This structure gave me three problems: how to connect the inlet and outlet ports to the external hydraulic lines, how to connect the drive shaft to the drive motor's shaft, and how to maintain the necessary seal while solving the first two problems. To solve these, I designed this part, which I call the connector block. The block has two holes on its end face that connect to the pump's inlet and outlet ports. The hole connecting to the pump's outlet port also has a stepped surface for an O-ring. These two holes are connected to two threaded holes on the side, where quick connect fittings can be installed to connect to the external lines. The bore beside is designed to hold a specially designed coupling. One end of the coupling has a slot to hold the pump's flat shaft, driving it to rotate together. The center of the coupling has a shaft hole to connect to the drive motor. The other side of the bore also has a stepped structure. The inner layer has a smaller diameter and is for a bearing, while the outer layer has a larger diameter and is used to place a micro oil seal. The circular groove concentric with the through hole is for an O-ring, which will fit tightly against the annular boss on the pump's end cap to create a seal. On the other end of the connector block, I also designed a motor mount to install the drive motor. There is also a spacer block between the motor and the mount, which serves two purposes. The first is to adjust the gap between the motor and the mount to clear the screw hole and provide a spot for the locking nut. It also allows me to adjust the position of the motor shaft and the coupling relative to the pump's drive shaft to avoid any interference between the three. The machining of the parts starts with the connector block. The first step is to machine the holes on the end face. The two holes near the corners are for mounting and fixing this hydraulic pump, and all that's needed is to drill straight through them. The one in the middle is a three-tiered bore, which is for the bearing and oil seal, and it's more complicated to machine. I successively enlarged the hole with 8mm and 10mm drill bits. Then, I used a 12mm drill bit to drill to the depth of the second tier of the three-tiered bore. Since the bottom of the hole drilled by a drill bit is conical, I also needed to use a flat end mill of the same diameter to flatten it. The third tier of this bore has a diameter of 15mm and is for the oil seal, which requires a good surface finish. So, I switched to a boring bar for this step. After machining all three tiers, I switched to different chamfering tools to successively chamfer each step. The second step is to machine the circular groove on the other end face. I used a CNC router for this process. At first, for a better video shot, I didn't use any cutting fluid, but later, for safety, I turned it on. After machining the circular groove, I reclamped the workpiece onto a manual milling machine and used a face milling cutter to face the surface. Then, I machined the inlet and outlet ports. I also needed to use an end mill to mill a stepped surface in the outlet port for the O-ring. The fourth step requires two separate clamping setups. I first machined the hole on one side, which connects to the outlet port on the end face. Then, I reclamped the workpiece to machine the hole on the other side, which connects to the inlet port on the end face. For the fifth step, I reclamped the workpiece with the top face facing up and used a radius chamfering tool to mill two rounded corners. The fit between the connector block and the pump seems decent. Finally, I'll tap threads into the two side holes to install the quick connect fittings. And with that, the connector block is finished. Next, I'll machine this special coupling from a small piece of 10 millimeter diameter chrome-plated smooth shaft. Chrome-plated smooth shafts are one of my favorite industrial products. For one, their surface is very smooth and wear-resistant. Second, they come in a wide range of specifications, and their dimensions are very precise. If chosen correctly, they also have good machinability. After some simple turning, the coupling is already taking shape. Next, I'll machine the motor shaft hole. First, by drilling a center hole, then a through hole. The fit between the motor shaft and this hole is very smooth, but that's not my goal. I need a rigid connection between the two. This tiny set screw will achieve that goal. To install it, I switched to a small milling machine. I'll mill a flat surface, drill a center hole, drill the tap hole, and then tap the thread. With that, the set screw thread hole is complete. The next step is to machine the slot on the other end face, which will connect to the pump's drive shaft. Finally, I'll machine the motor mount. The raw material is a 50 millimeter side, 3 millimeter thick aluminum angle. The process is simple, so I won't go into details here. These are the main parts of the pump. Next is the assembly and testing phase. First, I'll install the coupling onto the motor shaft and tighten the set screw. Then, I'll install the motor onto the motor mount. The black piece is a 3D printed part, whose purpose I mentioned earlier. Next, I'll install the oil seal and O-ring onto the connector block. Finally, I'll assemble the three parts and tighten them with screws. And with that, a miniature hydraulic pump for an RC model is complete. Let's power it on and test it. To save some trouble, I'm not using a remote control or ESC for this test. I'm using this brushless motor driver, which I built for another project. The black knob in the middle is a potentiometer, which I use to adjust the brushless motor's speed. Nothing sounds out of the ordinary, so let's try connecting the hydraulic lines. The hydraulic pump is running, but there are a lot of air bubbles. To be honest, I don't know the reason for this problem, so I'll leave it to you, the audience. If you know why, please let me know in the comments. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching all the way through. If you liked my video, please give it a like. If you have any other comments, please leave them below. Next time, we'll be making the directional control valve. See you in the next one.